All right, so here we are. We're at Chuck Levin's. I'm here with Evan. Evan, hello.
Hey.
How are you?
All right. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for joining me in this
video.
Of course. And we have two things up here that are very exciting. These were just announced, just released. They have them. Give them a call if you're interested in one. We have the Plexi. Now, these are the studio models. So these are basically faithful recreations of the bigger brothers. This here is a Mach 2 studio. Basically, it's the Plexi, and you could tell by the four input. And then we have the JCM 800. Again, faithful recreation of the bigger brother. These are the studio models, 20 watt with an output selector on the back, a wattage selector, I should say, on the back. And I figured maybe we'll just plug them in and give them a go.
Let's play them.
Okay.
Hear how they sound.
Any thoughts before we plug in? Any thoughts on these? That you may have?
Well, thoughts, it's nice to play Marshall, you know, not out of the biggest high stack that you can get lugging those around. So it's cool to have these and to kind of get that replica sound out of them without, you know, the real deal throwing your back out.
Sure.
So.
Yeah, 4x12s and full stacks aren't really a big thing much.
Yeah, no, not anymore. If you see them on stage, they're probably decoys.
But, right. Yeah, there's definitely a lot of bands, I think even big bands that we all love know. Use the 4x12s, you know, full stage stacks. But when you want tone, that's a, like you said, it's a tough thing to lug around.
Exactly.
Especially these came out in the, at least the JCM 800 came out in the 80s. So if you were 20 in the 80s, you're probably in your 40s or 50s now, and your back isn't as friendly as it used to be. So let's give a go. Let's start with the JCM 800. We have the Slash. That's actually the Slash Les Paul. Gorgeous guitar.
You want to play?
Let me give this a go.
Yeah, give it a little go.
And let me grab a pick. Going. Now, I have this turned up pretty loud right now. Basically, you know, the trick to a JCM 800 is turn everything on 7. So that's how I have everything set up, with the exception of the volume. The volume I have at about, what is that, 11 o'clock-ish?
A little bit.
Let's actually bring it down a tiny bit. We'll start
there.
There
you go.
I'm going to go on high input and... bring all the tones and all that stuff up. You ready?
Oh yeah.
It's definitely a lot of bite to it.
Oh Jesus.
A lot of bite. There we go, there's my bite. That's great. I mean, that's the sound.
That is it. Yeah, that's great.
I mean, think of how many amps, pedals, amps, modelers, everything that was all based off of what we're hearing right now. You know, that's definitely what's going on over here. The preamp is pretty much all the way. Do you want to fiddle with the preamp control?
Sure.
That's our gain level. Let's bring it down and we'll work our way up.
All right. We're at 6 right now. 12 o'clock right now.
Yeah, let's bring it all the way up.
All right.
I think this is the amp that we want to bring it
up.
Let's do
it.
That's great. This is a treat to play.
That is that bite right there.
It's right there, right?
Right there.
I am curious what the low does. Let's throw that on low. So this is basically a three-way toggle. You have standby in the middle, low, and then high. We were on high. Let's hear the difference with low. Definitely tames it down.
Yeah, I was going to say, it tames it quite a bit. You know, it's the bite's still there, but kind of restrained a little.
Yeah. I like it high. I mean, that's how that's supposed to sound.
I was going to say, it's got it. You're playing it the way it was born.
Maybe if you had, like these are passive pickups, maybe if you had something active, like some EMGs or something a little hotter, you might want to put that on low.
Yeah, I could see that.
You know, and I guess if you get to a point where the amp starts squealing, and you, like right now, that's all the way up, and it's fine. But if you had something that was a little hotter, or a lot of people use this amp, they'll throw like a tube screamer in front of it.
True, yeah.
Could make the front end a little too hot. You throw that on low, and I think you're good to go. You want to give this a whirl?
Sure, let's try it out.
There you go.
All right.
That's for you. Oh, you got one?
Here,
okay,
yeah.
Perfect. You know what's interesting? We both brought on the riffs with this amp.
I was going to say, you get a Les Paul in your hand out of a Marshall, and it's just like, you got to play those riffs. You got
to play the riffs.
But no, I like it a lot. I mean, it's like you said, that bite is just there. It's ever so present. It's like, there's almost, you feel like not held back at all with that.
And that's
definitely
the
when it was on the low setting, you know, you could kind of feel like you're subdued a little bit, maybe in tone. But this is, it's just like you're unleashed to the wild, and you're just...
You want to give the low a go?
Yeah, let's
see what
let's
we have.
Go.
Okay.
I was going to say the difference between those two is just
huge, right?
It's huge.
All right. So the next thing we have up here is the Mach 2 Studio, the Mini Plexi.
There you go.
Should we give this one a go?
Let's do it.
All right. So you keep the guitar.
All right.
Now, this amp, you could jump two channels because basically you have a high treble and a normal channel. And we could listen to both. So let's go in over here. Right now, everything is off. We also have the low and the high. Let's start with the high. I'm going to bring everything to, we're going to do the same thing to about 7.
Okay.
So we have presence, bass, middle, treble, all till 7. Now, we have the high treble and the normal. The high treble, so right here you could see the other volume, there's no sound because the channels aren't jumped. So let's just give this a go. So now we're going to go to channel 2 so you can hear the difference. So I'm going to roll that volume back.
All right.
All right, let's give that a little bit of a go. So now the trick is you just get like a patch cable. This is probably a tiny bit longer than normal, but you get like a little jumper cable from a pedal board. And what you do is you do one of these, you patch them together, go into one of the inputs, and now you could blend both. So let's give that a go and I'll dial them in. Give it a go. As I roll the treble back a little bit. You know, what the biggest difference between this style amp and that style amp is that has a basically gain. Mm-hmm. It has a gain control, which they call preamp. This one, there is no, it's just called loudness.
Loudness.
Because that's what it does.
At least they're blunt about it.
Yeah, at least they're blunt about it. But this is really, you know, this is pre-JCM 800 days where you would really depend on volume and volume would give you breakup.
Yeah.
You know, you're depending on power to breakup. So this is probably something like if you have a pedal board, maybe you have, you know, your favorite stomp boxes to help overdrive that a little bit. Otherwise, you know, you're probably not making somebody at home happy. Because this is going to be really, really loud. You can't get the gain at low volumes. You're going to need something to, like a pedal or something, to drive that.
Yeah, unless you have a garage that's probably soundproofed.
Right.
You know? So
yep.
you're going to be getting complaints from your neighbors because that thing is going to be loud.
But they both sound great. I'll tell you what, this is like, you almost want the set, you know.
That was good. You cannot go wrong. Turned up all the way, you cannot go wrong with these.
So what do you think? You think Marshall will keep coming out with more of these, the JCM 900?
I sure hope so, because they know what we like,
right?
And there's no reason to change that.
Seems like they were kind of late to the game with this, right? A lot of people...
It's like, why did it almost take so long?
But
at least they gave it to us.
They're here. They sound good.
Shouldn't complain. But
made in England, so they're the real deal.
The real deal, yep.
And that's it. So, Evan, thank you so much.
Of course. Thank
Appreciate
you for having
it.
Me.
So there it is. You have two brand new Marshall amps. They were just released at NAMM, Winter NAMM 2000. Mm-hmm. What year are we in?
Oh, man. Is it 19 already?
19.
2019.
Time flies when you're having
fun. It's weird to say it, 2019.
It does.
Wow.
So there it is. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a comment below. Which one did you like better? And what are your thoughts on these two amps? So thank you for watching. Leave you all off with one of those. Chuck Levins, give them a call. They have them in stock. And that's it. So thank you, Rock On. We'll see you later.